Today's story is Two Little Boys, Ten Big Plagues, written by Carol Craven Bates and illustrated by Janet Church Hopkins. If you would like a copy of this book, there's a link for it in the description. Chapter 2. The sun was barely up the next morning when Jalon arrived at the riverbank. He was carrying his cane fishing pole and two wooden buckets. The smaller bucket was filled to the brim with dough balls. The larger one was empty. Jalon was hoping to fill that one with the fish he caught. To his surprise, Mecho was already there and pulling out his second fish of the day. Mecho looked over at Jalon and giggled, "You better speed it up, Slowpoke. They're really hungry this morning. I just barely got my hook in the water until I had a fish on it. Hurry and throw in your line before I catch them all. I sure am glad you thought to bring some more bait. The way the fish are biting, we're going to be out in no time, and we sure don't want to take time to dig for worms." Excitedly, Jalon took his place on the bank beside Mecho. "I want to show you something. My dad made a brand new fish hook for me last night. He carved it out of a piece of bone from a ram. Dad told me it wouldn't be as strong as yours. Your hook is made out of an ox bone. He said that was the best kind, but sheep was all he had. It feels pretty sharp. I can hardly wait to try it out." Before Jalon could get situated and get his hook baited and into the water, something awful happened. The river turned blood red and started stinking. Instantly, dead fish, turtles, and frogs were floating everywhere. The boys jumped back as fast as they could. Mecho was so shocked, his fishing pole and his left leg went into the river before he could catch his balance. The boys looked at each other in disbelief. Terrified, Jalon snatched up his fishing pole and his two buckets. "Look at that! The river has turned into blood! This is scary! We better go tell everybody!" Mecho started to grab the bucket containing his two fish. To his horror, the water in the bucket had turned to blood as well. He dumped the contents out on the ground and threw the bucket as far away as he could. "We better get out of here. We need to go to your house and tell your mom first. My folks are both in town this morning. Nobody is going to believe this, you know. We'll have to bring them here to see for themselves." When the boys arrived at the home of Jalon, they were in for another surprise. All the water in the clay washtubs and all the water in the house had also turned to blood. Jalon went into the house and found his mother standing at the kitchen table. She was crying uncontrollably. Between breaths, she wailed, "Supper is ruined and our clothes are ruined." All the clothing the family owned that they weren't wearing was in the washtubs floating in blood. The lamb roast she was preparing for their evening meal was in the same disgusting condition. Jalon looked at Mecho, who was silently staring at them as if he was still in shock. Jalon put his arms around his mother and whispered, "What's happening, Mama? The Nile River has turned into blood, too." Jalon was still hugging his mother when his father came dashing into the house. Mr. Grossman had been forced to leave work early when the water he was using to make bricks suddenly changed into blood. Since he was working just a short distance downstream from where Pharaoh and his servants were gathered, it did not take him long to find out what had happened. When David realized the magnitude of the problem, he hurried home to his family as quickly as possible. Seeing the condition his wife was in when he arrived made him thankful he had hastened home. After his wife had calmed down considerably, Mr. Grossman had everyone sit down. "Let me tell you how all this mess came about. Apparently, Moses and Aaron went to the river to find Pharaoh. When they found him, they approached the king unannounced again. Another request was made that Pharaoh let us go worship our God. The three of them got into a big argument and they all started shouting. Just when Pharaoh thought he had the last word, Moses told his brother to strike the water of the Nile with his walking stick. Aaron did, and the river instantly turned to blood. Wanting to prove that was not a difficult task, Pharaoh called for his magicians. They used their enchantments to show Pharaoh they could turn water into blood too. Plus, as if that wasn't enough, Aaron stretched his rod over the streams, ponds, and pools, causing them to turn to blood. Can you believe it? Every drop of surface water in all of Egypt has turned into blood. It didn't seem to make any difference if the water was inside the houses or out. At every place I passed on the way home, the people were out in their yards. They were furious about the blood and the awful smell. Mr. Grossman started for the door. "We need to clean this place up and get rid of this horrible smell. We also need to get some fresh water right away." On my way home, I saw the Egyptians digging new wells. Evidently, all that water is okay. "I'll dig a hole out back so we can bury all this blood. Jalon, you and Mecho help me by bringing everything you can carry to the hole. Don't forget the water trough in the stable. You will need to bail that out. We will empty all this mess and bury it to keep the smell down. Then, we need to load all our pots and buckets on the ox cart and go get some good water." The Egyptians were giving water away to everyone that had a stone jar or clay pot. "Mecho, we'll stop by your house so you can gather several containers and take some fresh water to your folks as well."